It's been a hard day's night.
Like a pendulum do, Bobby's on bicycles two by two. Westminster Abbey, the Tower of Big Ben, the rosy red cheeks of the little children. Now if you huff and puff and you finally save enough money up to take your family on a trip across the sea, take a tip before you take your trip. Let me tell you where to go. Go to England, oh, England swings like a pendulum do. Bobby's own bicycles two by two. Westminster Abbey, the Tower of Big Ben, the rosy red cheeks of the little children. Mama's old pajamas and your papa's mustache, falling out the windowsill, frolic in the grass, trying to mock the way they talk fun, but all in vain. Gaping at the dapper men with derby hats and canes. England swings like a pendulum do. Bobby's own bicycles two by two. Westminster Abbey, the Tower of Big Ben, the rosy red cheeks of the little children. England swings like a pendulum do. Bobby's own bicycles two by two. Westminster Abbey, the Tower of Big Ben.
We'll be right back. portion of our video where we give you some ideas about things we've learned through the times that we've cruised.
Here's a tip. Some people say you've got to try the unique food dishes that are offered in the various places that you visit.
We say no, you don't have to.
Or no, no way. It's safe if the local specialties make sense or they're pairings of two great foods. Like a ham and cheese sandwich in Paris. Everybody likes ham. Everybody likes cheese. Everybody likes bread. That's a winner.
Or bangers and mash in London.
Yeah, when you translate bangers and mash into American, you see that it's sausage and mashed potatoes. That's a surefire winner. I don't know why the Americans didn't come up with that great marriage of Jimmy Dean and Yukon Gold, but my hat's off to the British for inventing bangers and mash.
Another pairing of two great foods is fish and chips.
But if it has a name that sounds odd or doesn't make sense, I'm saying beware. Here's a warning about a food that we found in the British Isles. Black pudding. Stay away from this one. First of all, black and pudding don't go together. That doesn't make sense. That's a red flag right away. What is it, licorice-flavored pudding? I don't think so.
Look at the picture. It's not anything like our pudding.
So, we got our research team on it, and they found out what black pudding really is. Here's the recipe. You can see that the main ingredient is pig's blood. If it wasn't enough to have blood in the thing, it has to be pig's blood. And what kind of pig's blood?
Fresh.
Ugh. Apparently, if you use stale pig's blood, it ruins the whole dish.
Then you throw in some salt and pepper, oatmeal.
And some small bits of pork fat and onions to kind of tone down the blood taste. And then you pour in some milk.
What were the English thinking?
I don't know. Were they trying to turn our kids into some kind of porcine vampires? Porcine. That means pigs, just like bovine means cows. That's a little added tidbit that we're giving you for free. Anyway, we recommend that you stay away from this local cuisine in the places that you visit, with one exception.
It is okay. In fact, we strongly suggest that when you're in France, you eat some French pastries.
Oh, yeah. So, that's it for today's edition of Cruising with the Kesslers. See you next time.
Goodbye.
We'll be right back.
No.
Okay.
When you're in France. Goodbye. Do not make me do this again.
No, I think we're done.